No better feeling than delivering exactly what you have been asking for. And you've been asking for an affordable, high-power PoE++ switch for quite some time now. So here it is, the first of its kind, the CRS320. I can already see it in hotels, conference halls, offices and high-rise buildings, running all your power-hungry 4K security camera clusters, ad panels, access points and even industrial automation systems. That's the beauty of PoE++, right? But first, let's start with the basic specs. Inside this powerhouse is one of our most trusted Marvel switch chips. The same one you might recognize from our ISP bestseller, the NetPower 16P. Phenomenal performance for the price. You'll be using VLAN filtering like it's nothing, and you can even do hardware offloaded layer 3 routing. The port density is pretty good on its own, but PoE out is the real kicker here. So Ethernet 1-8 is your regular gigabit Ethernet with PoE out with the 802.3 AFAT standard. Now Ethernet ports 9-16, that's what you came for, right? The high power PoE++ or 802.3BT standard. Last time I checked, it turned out that this CRS might be your best bang for the buck per PoE++ port on the market. But what good is an all-rounder switch with no uplink? That's why we've added 4 SFP Plus ports for 10 gigabit fiber connectivity. Here's the craziest part. These PoE++ ports can output up to 90 watts of power. We've seen a couple of unusual use cases, for example, a security camera that comes with a built-in heating element for colder climates. Or individual PoE-powered light fixtures for conference rooms, so that every light can be monitored and managed by the network administrator. As if they don't have enough work already, am I right? When it comes to powering other power-hungry devices, you should check the wattage and the power consumption, as there are options here. The switch comes with a solid 600-watt power supply. And we've reserved extra space for an additional PSU in case you need to raise the power output all the way to 1150 watts. Here's the extra PSU, by the way. You can order them separately, but do check the power consumption of your setup. You might not need the extra wattage after all. Looking ahead, you can expect more PoE++ products. I would definitely recommend this type of PoE to power a wide range of demanding third-party devices. The new PoE++ is compatible with the latest MikroTiks, such as the CRS 504, 510, and FTC11. For other ATAF and passive PoE MikroTik devices, we suggest using CRS354 and CRS328 PoE switches for optimal compatibility. So there you have it, our very first high-power PoE++ switch with the best price per BT port, a full version of Router's version 7, and an extra PSU expansion slot. This is your opportunity to make cable management easier, cleaner, and smarter